Hey folks, Wausau EAT. So I'm sitting here in the napping chair. My back is out. And I just got some packages loaded up, all the orders. But can't hardly stand right now. So I don't know for sure how this is going to go, but got a little piece of Flint River. This was a busted point. And see if we can make something out of it. It's got a big square edge, of course, where it busted off. And I'm going to get rid of the square edge first. And we'll see where we go from there. I was wanting to preserve some of that color in it, but I'm not for sure. We'll see if we get the square edge off. Today is my daughter's birthday. My daughter and my son, actually. Our oldest son is 36 today. Hard to believe, but he is. I might just make the point here, get rid of this over here, or I could make that the point and get rid of some of this. Might also be an option. Pretty thick along that part. This was the tip off a much larger, if I remember right, much larger piece I was working on. It's got a lot of color in it right there. I got a lot of thickness to get rid of down here. So I may try to run some flakes in on this and go ahead and make this the point up here. Threw a hinge in right there when I I'm not sure exactly why it did that, but it did. Indirect would be helpful here, but I can't get my leg up in the position to do indirect because my back right now. So whatever I do, I'm going to have to do it all by pressure flaking. use the coarse abrader. You guys see me going back and forth between a coarse abrader and this fine abrader, or finer abrader. I use that coarse abrader when I'm wanting to turn an edge quick. And the finer one does a much better job of on the edge of strengthening the edge. The coarse abrader tends to put little micro fractures in it, and it's just not as stout an edge as bring this in quite a bit. It's a rainy day today and cold, and supposed to get colder. It's nice and warm in the shop though, for sure. Use that abrader to take that edge back some. Still trying to push flakes in as I'm going here. That one came all around into there. Ooh, I just broke it. Doggone it. Yeah, I busted that out. Well, that's going to change what I was wanting to do with this. For sure. I wish that wouldn't have broke, but I did. Not sure what I want to make out of this quite yet. Got an undetached flake there. I've been making a lot of Keokuk type points. Keokuk type bird points. And this one has that going on for it right now. But I might do something a little bit different, maybe. Let's see, I think I'm gonna switch to, I don't have my Mike Tough hand flakers. I've mentioned in their video that I sold mine. I have more coming on the way, but I also have some of the Mike Tough's new boppers available too. I don't think there's too many left, but there is some, and more on the way. I've grown to love making these little points. I really do enjoy it. The subject had come up, someone had mentioned to me that flint napping is a rich man's hobby, and I don't think that's true. You can spend as much or as little money on it as you want. If you're fortunate to live in an area where you can collect some flint or whatever, then you can get your material for free. And even if you don't, you can nap glass. And there's all that you want for free. And you can buy a box of flakes. Like this one, or, just flakes. And pretty cheap. From myself and others, and make bird points just like this. Buy a medium box of flakes, there's literally there's a lot of points in there, 100 or more, probably something like that. That's a lot of flint napping. So it's not a rich man's hobby. You can make it as expensive as you want or go as cheap as you want. You don't even have to buy tools or any of that stuff. You can just, you know, use an old piece of antler or hammer stones. And keep your toolkit pretty minimal, or you can get all the new cool stuff. So in my opinion, flintknapping is wide open to everybody. Just depends on what you want to do with it. Now, if you want to do a bunch of fog napping, then you're going to have to invest in a bunch of equipment. Or buy fog blanks, which is... I've only ever bought one, and it wasn't cheap. But it wasn't cheap because there's a lot of work that goes into producing those. But you definitely don't need all the latest, greatest everything to flintknap. Imagine early people had access to all the antler and stuff they wanted from kills and scavenge kills and just whatever, sheds. If you're living your whole life out in the woods, you're gonna have an abundance of those things. I'm gonna change this. Whoops, lost my pad. I got a really cool piece of Mookite here too. That it's super thin flake, but I'm not sure if I can get a point out of it or not without busting it into a million pieces. But it is a pretty cool flake though. Got good color to it. I'll be right back. I need to look in the book. Okay, we're back. Do some notches in there. Attempt to, anyways. attempt to make a little bird point dovetail. That's what I'm trying to make here. Looking pretty good so far. Against a different color, maybe. It's actually a pretty decent looking little point. I like it. I'm gonna sharpen this thing up and I made a point. It wasn't a very good point. It was probably the smallest point I ever made the other day, and I'd lost it. It fell off my leg in here. I looked for it for about half an hour, and finally just gave up. It was pretty tiny. I might have lost this one. Hold on a minute. Oh, there it is. Let me show up on this one a little bit better. Let's try and stay in frame here. When you're making these little points, everything's the same as making a big point, just on a smaller scale. Still going through all the same procedures. It's a pretty cool little point. Got the tip turned over some though. still have it turned over. I was trying to get that tip pointy. And I moved it over too far in the process. Somehow managed to gouge myself on something here. I guess I should have just left that tip alone. We're gonna call that good, I think. A little dovetail. Zoom out a bit here. Wipe it off. It's a cool little point. It's got really nice color in it. I'm gonna grab the book here. There's the dovetails. Pretty cool. Could concave that basis a little bit. I actually don't know if any of them were actually tiny like this. Most of them I see are big. I'd have to look, but we were making a miniature point, so. Pretty cool. I like it. Another one for the bird point collection. But anyhow, appreciate y'all watching. I'm all bloody. Sorry about that. Pretty cool little point, though. Appreciate y'all watching. We'll catch you on the next one. Keep napping. I'm probably going to be making a few more of these because my back is just kind of goofy. But I kind of like to make a miniature Clovis. I like to make a miniature little Calf Creek, some stuff like that. Just some different ones. On a miniature scale, even smaller than this, if possible. But we'll see. Not sure about how to flute the little Clovis yet. I guess just with pressure, but we'll see. Anyhow, appreciate y'all watching. Y'all keep napping.